श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराण की जय। श्री नताय गौर हरि बोल। श्री गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय। वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। ओम नमो भगवते पुराण पुरुषोत्तमाय। ओम जयति पराशर सूनु सत्यवती हृदय नंदनोव्यासो यस्यास्य कमलगलतम वाग्मय ममतम जगत्पिबति विश्वसर्ग विसर्गादि नवलक्षण लक्षतम श्री कृष्णाक्षम परम धाम जगद्धाम नमामि तत्। हृदय से प्रेरणया प्रवर्तितो हम बराक रूपोपि तस्य हरे पदकमलम। वंदे श्री चैतन्य देवस्य वंदे हम श्री गुरु श्रीयुत पदकमलम श्री गुरु वैष्णवांश्च श्री रूपम साग्र जातम सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं साधुतं परिजन सहितं श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य देवम श्री राधा कृष्ण पादाम सहगण ललता श्री शाखान्वितांश्च नारायण नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयन्तीरये वाञ्छाकर्तृभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पत्तानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। हे श्री सनातन प्रभो करुणाम्बुराशे हे रूप दुर्गत जनैक दयावलोक हे भक्ति सुमते रघुनाथ दास श्री जीव मे कुरुमन मते हृदयांतरा तुलसी कांगनम यत्र यत्र पद्मगुणानि च पुराण प्रश्नम यत्र तत्र सन्निहितो हरि। बोलो श्री वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। परम श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराण वेरी वेरी ऑस्पिशियस श्री श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराण द वोकल इनकार्नेशन ऑफ श्री कृष्णचंद्र एंड इन मुक्ति स्कंद एकादश स्कंद इज मुक्ति स्कंद प्रीवियसली इन द डायलॉग ऑफ श्री दत्तात्रेय मुनि एंड श्री यदु महाराज श्री दत्तात्रेय भगवान हैज टेकिन सेड दैट आई हैव टेकिन लेसन फ्रॉम 24 गुरुज एंड अमंग देम टू गुरु आर मेन वन वाज दैट बॉर्न एंड द अदर इज दैट क्राफ्टमैन। सो वन शुड have the main thing, his mood, that is the main thing, how to maintain his mood, that is the sadhana bhakti, to take the mood and to take the one's bhav that is taken by Sri Diksha Guru and it is Bhindikira and the other is the craftsman, how to one should do the bhakti of nine types. In next chapter, Sri Bhagwan saying that there is a स्वाभिष्ट भाव में स्वाभिष्ट भाव संबंधी स्वाभिष्ट भाव अनुकूल स्वाभिष्ट भाव अविरुद्ध एंड स्वाभिष्ट भाव विरुद्ध. सो स्वाभिष्ट भाव अनुकूल इज वर्णाश्रम धर्म. वर्णाश्रम धर्म ऑलवेज गिव सच द एटमोस्फियर बाई विच ए पर्सन कैन इजीली डू एंड इट इज वेरी मच मैचिंग टू भक्ति. वर्णाश्रम धर्म इज वेरी मच मैचिंग टू भक्ति. The other way of life that is not so much matching as the varnashram dharma is matching to it. So, mayo diteshvavetaha swadharmeshu madashraya. A person who is avetaha, very much conscious, swadharmeshu madashraya, and is following his dharma, even then madashraya, he has taken shelter of mind, that means he has taken the initiation from Sri Gurudev and having the shelter. Varnashram kulacharam, and he is following the varnashram dharma, varna and ashram dharma. Ashram dharma is a very profound way of how to a person will get himself in the better status of his adhyatma or his meditation or bhakti. So that is ashram dharma is ashram dharma is for individual increasement, and the world dharma is for a social atmosphere, and that will be very helpful and it will increase the whole society in a better position. A very cultured and very developed society, that can be done by ashram dharma, because ashram dharma in brahmachari is reading, the grahasthi is doing the work for whole society, vanaprastha is doing the work how to increase one's own personality, and the sannyas, he will get the absolute goal. So in this way, the ashram dharma is very much important also, and it will make the whole society completely developed. So varnashram kulacharam akamatma sukhamachari. Even then, a person is following varna and ashram dharma, even then he should be nishkam bhakti, nishkam karma. He should do akamatma. Akamatma, that means if he will do the work for getting swarg or the other desire, moksha, swarg and moksha, then he will not achieve the goal of bhakti. So akamatma, one should do nishkam karma. The nishkam karma will be, the karma will be karma yoga, while he will complete four term and conditions. The karma will be karma yoga. The first condition is that I am not the doer. I am only an instrument of Shri Krishna, and whatever Shri Krishna wants to make me do, make me done, I am doing the same thing. So that means I am not the karta, akartatva buddhi. The first term condition is akartatva buddhi. The second condition is that whatever I am doing, I am not requiring and desiring its result. Duty is my behalf. The result is not my concern. So that should be, we should be accept this. So nishkamta. akartitv buddhi nishkamta. The third thing is my every work should be related to the bhakti. That is buddhi yoga. And whatever I am doing, even I am doing the natural activities, that is also to improve and promote my bhakti. So that is buddhi yoga. And the third thing is, while I am doing work, then there will be some result. Because action has reaction. The work has its result. And if there is result, then I will surrender it to Shri Krishna. So, karma samarpan. So, four things are the main thing that makes karma, karma yoga. Again, akartitv buddhi, nishkarma, phal abhisandhi abhav, buddhi yoga and karma samarpan. If you will adopt these four things, then this karma will be karma yoga. And while he is doing karma yoga, then his mind will be very much clear. Chitta shuddhi. The cleanness of his heart will be took place by nishkam karma. And while the chitta is nishkam, then jnana or bhakti can be done in a better way. So in this way, the jnana cannot be manifest unless there is nishkam karma. But bhakti can be manifest in any way. Bhakti is so swatantra that bhakti can be manifest in any heart. But jnana will only manifest if a person has done nishkam karma. So the one name of jnana is also naishkarmya. Synonyma is jnana and naishkarma is paryayvachi, synonyma. So naishkarma means jnana will always manifest, always rise from nishkam karma. If there is no nishkam karma, jnana cannot be got it. So that is the main thing. So akamatma samachari. Shri Krishna is saying one should be akamatma. That means he should do the nishkam karma. And if he is doing nishkam karma, then so the case is with bhakti. A bhakti will also do if the nishkam karma, then he will get a better atmosphere of bhakti. Otherwise, by doing sakam karma, his bhakti will be registered, bhakti will be hindranced. The hindrance will become in bhakti. Anvikshetu vishuddhātmā dehinā viṣyātmanā. Anvikshetu. Anvikshetu means one should always be cautious of ātma-tattva. Anu-ikshana. Anu means continuously. Ikshan means one should try to achieve the satya padartha, truth thing. And truth is atma. Atma of Brahma is truth. So anvikshetu means one should be very much conscious of truth. And he should practice and he should be effortful for that, to get that truth, to realize that truth. So andikshit, vishuddhātmā, he should be very vishuddh. His heart should be very much clean, vishuddhātmā. That means without jealousy and without desire. Two things makes this heart dirty. One is jealousy and the other thing is desire. If he is free from these two things, then he will be Vishuddhātmā. His mind will be very much clear. देहिनां विषयात्मनां कुलेषु तत्त्वध्यायिनो सर्वारम्भ विपर्ययः वन शुड ऑलवेज ऑब्जर्व दिस यस यस these are the side effect of desire because काम and क्रोध are not two things. काम converts, काम transforms in the form of क्रोध. While we are requiring anything, desiring anything, and if there is hindrance in our desirement, then that desire will be turned into the anger, क्रोध. Raag and Dvesh, that is also, yes, that is synonym. Very, very fine. Raag means whatever facilities we are achieving, let me achieve this, those facilities continuously. That is Raag. And Dvesh is, if there is hindrance in their, those facilities, and I am not getting that facilities, or any hindrance come in that that position, then person will be Dvesh. He will do the enmity, Dvesh. So Raag and Dvesh is not two things. The opposite of Raag is Dvesh. Raag means whatever we are getting, we should, it should be continued. And let us use it, that is Raag. And Dvesh is, if there is hindrances, then we do not disliking those hindrances. That disliking is Dvesh. So Dehinam Vishatmanam. He should always consider that Dehinam Vishatmanam, if a person is always having desires, Vishatmanam, and he is desiring some subjects, Shabdas Parshurukraskand, let me use them. Let me experience them. Kulesh Tattva Dhyanino. If a person will be concentrate on Tattva, that the things which I am getting, are they the form of happiness? He will find that in result they are not happiness. And in the result they are giving the sorrow. Only. So, Kuleshu Tattva Dhyayeno, what is truth and what is false? Having this discrimination, Tattva Dhyana, if then it is truth, then I will accept it, I will do it. And what is not true, and it, if it is false, or if it is illumination, illusion, then I will leave it. If it is illusion, then I will believe it. So Kuleshu Tattva Dhyanino. So he should always remember or consider the Tattva, the truth, Sarvarama Paparyam, and he will find that whatever he is doing it for the motive to get sukh or happiness, but in result he is getting the sorrow, the sadness. So sarvarambha viparyam, arambha means his activities are giving the adverse result. Sarvarambha viparyam. So Gulesh Tattva Dhyanino, if he will consider the tattva, that means atma tattva, the true thing, truth, then he will find that all activities from which all other items from which I am thinking that I am getting happiness, that is not happiness, it will convert and it will result at last that sorrow. So sarvarama viparyam suptasya vishyamoko dhyayato va manoratha ज्ञानात्मकत्वात् विफलः तथा वेदात्मधि गुणे सुप्तस्य विषयालोकः. एज ए पर्सन इज स्लीपिंग एंड ही सीन द ड्रीम्स. इन ड्रीम्स ध्यायतो वा मनोरथ. सो इन द पोजिशन ऑफ द ड्रीम एंड इन द पोजिशन ऑफ इमेजिंग ध्यायतो वा मनोरथ. इफ ए पर्सन इज जस्ट कंसिडरिंग एंड ही इज थिंकिंग ऑफ मनोरथ हिज डिजायर्स देन समटाइम्स द थिंग्स कम्स देयर. सो इन स्वप्न ऑल्सो ही विल गेट द रिजल्ट. He will get the subject as well as in imagination also one can get the things and results, subjects. Shamtasparsha Rupa Sadgan, they can be achieved in imagination as well as in swap. In Jagrat Avastha, our sthul sharir is the receptive. In Swapna Avastha, our sthul sharir is merged into the mind and mind is receptive. The receiver is mind. In Sushupti, our sthul and sukshma, both bodies merged into prana and the prana is working there, but sthul and shul, both sukshma, both sharir are getting bath but not merged. They are null and void. Being null and void, they are getting bath but they are not merged. And while we are having the sound sleep, shushupti, even then we have the desire to be evoked. While we sleep, we have this desire, so let me evoke at the right time on 6 a.m. So we require it, or on 5 a.m. let me. We never sleep to remain sleeping for the unlimited time. So we have the desire of awakening in the sleeping evening. So then sthul sharir and sukshma sharir both are getting bath. They are being null and void, but they are not merged. They are there. And at that time, tamogun is so much greater that tamogun always suppressed and it covers our sthul body as well as sukshma body, and even our ahankar is also became null and void. The karyakoti ahankar is also becomes null and void. It is also bath. Ahankar ka bhi bath hua, pantu lay nahi hua. The original, we have two types of ahankar. One is karyakoti and the other is the original koti. Natural. So natural ahankar is there, and natural ahankar is always Satchit Anand. So while we awake, at that time Satyagun has not come so far. We are awaiting. Satyagun is coming, but it is not come. It has not come. The Tamogun is removed. There is no Tamogun. But Rajogun is also not coming. It will come afterward. So in this way, neither we are at that time fully having Sattugun, not Rajogun, not Tamogun. So that is the Gunhin, Gunless position. And due to Gunless position, the Atma Tattva, the glimpse of that Atma Tattva can be seen, and we feel at that very little moment that Sukh Maham Aksu Aksam, I was in sukha and I was sleeping. Nakinchit avedisham. So that means our jivatma was the witness of itself as well as it was the witness of ignorance also. अज्ञान की भी साक्षी जीवात्मा है और स्वस्वरूप की भी साक्षी जीवात्मा है. वी आर नॉट थिंकिंग इट बाय आवर माइंड बिकॉज बुद्धि वाज ऑल्सो स्लीपिंग एट दैट टाइम. सुषुप्ति बुद्धि वाज नॉट, अहंकार वाज नॉट देयर, नथिंग वाज देयर. दैट मीन्स देयर वाज नल एंड वॉइड, देयर वाज गेटिंग ओनली बाथ. देयर वाज नॉट activate, there was not, there was in the unactivate position, but there was not merged. In moksha, they will merge into prakriti. That is the difference between shushupti and moksha. Shushupti is not moksha, pralaya is not moksha. In pralaya, the trigun are being null and void. Trigunas are being unactivated. But they are in pralaya, they are not merged. But in moksha, they are left and they are merged into the Brahma. That is the difference. So jagrat, swapna, sushupti, pralaya and moksha. These are five positions. And whole five positions are different to each other. So he said ki suptasya vishaloko dhyayito va manoratha. Why ji?
Between Shri Krishna
and moksha, and moksha are difference.
Yes,
in pralaya guna are there, but they are just not doing any work, and but in moksha a person feels his soul different from designation. Upadhi se apne aap ko bhinn karke dekha, ye moksha ki sthiti hai. Upadhi ka alag ho jana और आत्मा का अलग हो जाना. डेजिग्नेशन इज क्वाइट डिफरेंट टू मी, दैट इज मोक्ष. आई एम नॉट बॉडी, दिस थिंकिंग. एंड केवल उसको पोस्टपोन हो जाना. इन प्रलय द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ त्रिगुण आर पोस्टपोनेड ओनली, बट दे आर देयर. सो दैट इज द डिफरेंस. मृत्यु इज नथिंग. Mrityu is just one, the mind and soul is accepting a new body and he is leaving the old one body. He is leaving the relationship with the old body where the relationship is broken. The death of that body will commence, but where the relationship is a new relationship is a joint, that body will be born. So mrityu is quite different. So jagrat, swapna, sushupti, mrityu, pralaya and moksha, these not five but six things are there, and they have the different positions. So he is saying of shushupti or imagination or swapna. In jagrat one can imaginate, in swapna he can see the things vishay in by his mind, and in shushupti he is not seeing anything, not desiring anything, but his desires are just slept and they are there in bhavana. He has to the bhavana that let me awake. But they are not working. In Pralaya, his bhavana and other things, his karma and guna, both are postponed only. They are not working. But in moksha, he gets rid of those desires and gets rid of those through. So that is the difference. So, nanatmakatva vipala tatha bhedatma dhigunai. But in imagination and in dream, whatever he is getting, nanatmakatva vipala, because they are indrijan, they are not true, they are in imagination, so they are vipala. A person is thinking that I am become a emperor and I am on the throne, but he is a poor man. So nanatukatva vipala, as soon as he will awake, his swapna will be ruined and swapna will be vanished. So nanatukatva vipala tatha bhedatmadhi gunai. In the same way, a person is getting bhed buddhi in jagrat avastha also. So here two swapna are there. One swapna is vyavaharik swapna and the other swapna is from the point of view of adhyam. This whole universe is also a dream. Our life is also a dream. So that is another dream. But in dream, we are seeing dream. That means we are sleeping and then we are also seeing dream. So sometimes as we see the film in the film, cinema in the cinema, in the same way, the whole universe, whole creation is just like dream. And it will not stay ever. But in our daily life, in our routine life, we also sleep and then we also see dreams. So it can be seen, it can be said that we are seeing the dream in the dream. And sometimes it is also, we feel it, that we are sleeping and seeing the dream. So in dream we can also see the dream. So he is saying, so nanatmakatva vipala tatha bhedatmadhi gunai. In the same way, nanatmakatva, because all this is imagination, so it is vipala, it has no meaning. Tatha bhedatmadhi gunai. And by imagination, the mind is transforming himself into the various forms. In psychology, this is said that our mind has three parts: conscious, unconscious, and subconscious. In conscious mind, there is ego, aham. And that aham does not allow us to do anything that is not competent to our personality or our society. Whatever personality in a society or whatever personality I have increased so far, so that personality is there, and ego always allow us to do according to that personality. But the desires always rises, desires always rise in our mind. That ego is such a powerful guard that he did not allow him to come in the cabin of a conscious mind. He suppressed him and ingrained it, thus deta hai, in the sense of a unconscious and conscious mind. So whatever desire they are rising. The ego, just put it into the unconscious mind and conscious mind. But while we are sleeping, then the ego becomes weaker. But those desires are not ruined, they are not destroyed. They are still living in unconscious mind and conscious mind. And as soon as the pehredar, that guard, becomes slack, it becomes unpowerful, those desires comes out, revives, and they come into the cautious mind. And mind has this quality that mind can take many forms. मन में अनेक रूप धारण करने की सामर्थ्य है. सो एट दैट टाइम माइंड बिकेम्स बेड, माइंड बिकेम्स पिलो, माइंड बिकेम्स द पिक्चर, माइंड बिकेम्स द ग्लास, माइंड बिकेम्स द ड्रिंक. एंड वी आर ड्रिंकिंग, वी आर ईटिंग, वी आर डूइंग सो मेनी वर्क, एंड वी आर ऑर्डरिंग. माइंड बिकेम सर्वेंट, माइंड बिकेम्स फैन, माइंड बिकेम्स the palace. And we are seeing, so mind has such quality that it can transform itself into many forms. And at that time, by our imagination, those things always come in our dream, and the dream is appear there. But no dream can be more than 13 minutes. This is also very amazing. Our dreams are not more than 13 minutes. And in 13 minutes, we can see our three lives even. So that can be seen. We always remember the end of the dream, but not the beginning of the dream. This is very amazing. theory of dream says that normally we does not remember from where the dream was started. We know that dream is ended in this point, but the start is not remains. Sometimes whatever we see in dream, that is which whatever we have ever seen in our real life at any time, and that revives in our mind. So that is the sock. So he is saying ke nanatmakatva viphalah, because it is not related to our soul. It is related to our mind, and mind has nanatmak. Mind has the quality of transforming itself into many forms. So those subjects which we are experiencing in swapna or in imagination, so in our fantasies or in our dreams. So in fantasy and dreams, whatever we are seeing, that is vifala, that becomes vifal. Taya bhedatma dhigunai. In this way, because taya tatha bhedatma dhigunai, by indriyai, he is seeing so many differences. And those differences and those subjects are not ever lasting. They are not true. And they convert into the sadness. So, Sri Krishna is saying, ki nivritta karmam seveto pravruttam mat parastyaje. If a person wants to achieve me, he should always be cautious of nivritta karma. Nivritta karma means by doing those work, I will not be tied. That is called Nimitta Karma. And from which I will be tied, that is Pravritta Karma. If I will be, I will get the result of those karma, and those karma will make time. So that is Pravritta Karma, and that tininess will remove me, will lead me away from Sri Krishna. But the Nivritta Karma is always will increase the unattachment toward the worldly things, and our attachment will be much more profound in the form, lotus feet of Sri Krishna. So Nivritta and Pravritta, by which the bandhan is gotten, that is called Pravritta, and by which the bandhan is released, that is called Nivritta. So Nivritta Karmam Seveto Pravrittam Bhakpara Tejish. One should always be cautious, and he should think before doing the work. Does this work will lead me to Sri Krishna, or it will be make me far from Sri Krishna? Pravrittam Bhakpara Tejish. Jigyasayam Samprabhutto Nadriyat Karma Chodana. If a person is Jigyasayam Samprabhutta, Jigyasayam means if a person want to get moksha, and he want to get the, what is the beauty of Sri Krishna, what is the sweetness of Krishna, if he has this Jigyasa, this query, or he has this query, how I can get my original form, my happy and full of joy form, Anandamaya Swarup, how I can get? Then he should Nadriyat Karma Chodanam. Karma Chodanam means, Karma Nodanam means, by doing this karma, I shall get Swarup. And if I shall do this unallowed work, unadmissible work, then I will have to go to the Narak, hell. That is Karma Nodana. So it is called Nodana or Chodana. Nodana means he will be doing any work for fear or greed. Doing by this, I will get the result, sukh, and by doing this, I will get the dukh. So, nadriyat karma chodana. One should not do according to the shastra, that do this and do not do this. One should always do the things, how I can better get Sri Krishna Charita. Yaman Abhikshan Seveto Niyaman Matparas Pachit. A person should practice Yam and Niyam. Yam means by which our Gyanendri can be controlled. That is Yam. And Niyam means by which our Karmendri are being controlled. By which, as Shabda, Sparsh, Rupa, Ras, Gandha, these are the Gyanendri, the subject of Gyanendri. And now I will not listen anything. I will be in the isolation, in my kutiya, bhajan kuti. I will live there. So, I am rejecting the Shabd. I will close my eyelids and I will not see. I will close my eyes. That means rejecting the Roop. I will not sniff anything. Rejecting of the smell. I will take to breath. That means rejecting the taste, the shabd sparsh rup ras gandh. So this is yam. And niyam is that I will do this, I will do this. So now I will not move. Now I will sit on the asana. So that is yam niyam. So yaman abhiksham seveto niyaman mat parakvacha. Madhvikyam guru shantam upasit madatmakam. And one should take shelter of Shri Guru, spiritual master. The qualities of spiritual master is mad abhigyam, who knows me. That means who has experience and who has the witnessed me. Mad abhigyam, who knows me better. Shantam, mad abhigyam guru shantam. Shantam means in sukh dukh, both positions, in any position, he is transparent. He is shant, he is have the transparency. Madhvigyam guru shantam upasit madatmakam. So one should go to Shri Gurudev, who is madatmakam, whose whole work are for Shri Krishna, madatmakam. So madhvigyam guru shantam upasit madatmakam. The other qualities are, the main thing is madatmakam. Main thing is madatmakam. The other thing is tatastha lakshan, whose mind is just joined to me. He is actually guru. Otherwise it is not very much important, and it is not essential that guru should be very much learned. It is not possible, because every person will not get the guru like Shukdev, like Sankadev, like Jalbharat. We cannot get. So normally we have to take shelter of Madhyam Guru. And Madhyam Guru is Ishware Tadhineshu Paleshu Cha Dushasu Cha Prema Maitri Kripa Upeksham Vyaktaroti Sam Madhyam. So we will get Madhyam Guru. Yes. Yes, that is the model, that is the ideal. But according to the best model, we cannot achieve that type of guru. So it is actually, if we will be very much anxious, and we will always examine that does this person has those qualities or not, then it will be sometimes very much unhealthy to us, because at that way we will be always aparadhi, and we will see aparadhi. So a normal way, in a general way, we should see those guru, and we should think, we should leave it on the Shri Krishna, that Shri Krishna want to accept me, and I have accepted this guru who has come to me, and through this guru Shri Krishna will bestow his kindness on me. So one should think, and that is that examination or that discretion is before taking the shelter. If he has taken shelter, then he should not, never he should examine his guru. Then he should think that my guru is Shri Krishna himself, and whatever is appropriate to me, Shri Guru, Shri Krishna will give me through this resource, through this guru. So this one should not. No. नहीं, धर्म के द्वारा भक्ति में अनुकूलता मिलेगी, परंतु धर्म को धर्म का पालन करना, वर्णाश्रम धर्म का पालन करना, फॉलोइंग वर्णाश्रम धर्म कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली फेच अस थ्रू अस इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ श्री कृष्ण। ये मुख्य बात। सो हाँ बस ये है मदात्मक। इनमें यहाँ पर जो क्वालिटीज दी गई हैं, मधभिज्ञम, गुरु शांतम, उपासितम, मदात्मकम, मदात्मकम इज द मेन थिंग। ही शुड हैव रिलेशनशिप विद श्री कृष्ण एंड ही शुड बी सरेंडर टू श्री कृष्ण, दैट इज द मेन थिंग। बट अदर थिंग आर को हेल्पिंग, दे आर हेल्पिंग, दैट ही इज मधभिज्ञम, दैट मीन्स ही इज ए स्कॉलर, ही हैज रेड so many things, or shantam, he is shant, or amanya, he is not abhimani, he is not very much proud, arrogant, he is not amanya, he is not arrogant, masara, amasara, he is not having the jealousy with any other, daksha, he is very much clever, Nirmama, he is not having attachment with his any other person. Dhrid Savurda, but he has the Dhrid Savurda. He should love his disciple, Dhrid Savurda. These are the outer, they are tatastha lakshan. They are not the main lakshan. They are co-qualities, helping qualities. Main is madhatmika. Main thing is madhatmika. He should be back.
What is the external manifestation of madhatmika?
Madhatmika. हाँ ठीक है, मदात्मक। मदात्मक का तात्पर्य he should be loving to Shri Krishna and always remembering Shri Krishna. मदात्मक means his activities, his thoughts, both. Activities as well as thoughts, as well as his emotions. Thought, emotion and activities are joined to Shri Krishna, he will be called Madhatma. That means he should have love with Shri Krishna, he should have the theory and he should be fun that Shri Krishna is the main goal of every जीव। दिस थॉट माने इन दर्शन, इन विचार, इन भाव एंड इन कर्म, विचार भाव कर्म, ये तीनों कृष्ण में होने चाहिए, वो मदात्मक। विचार भी, भाव भी, कृष्ण भी, हिज इमोशन, हिज थॉट्स एज वेल एज हिज एक्शंस शुड बी रिलेटेड टू श्री कृष्ण, हिज मदात्मक। अमान नमस्वर दक्ष निर्ममो दृढ़ असत्वर, ही शुड नॉट बी वेरी मच हेस्टी, असत्वर। ए पर्सन इज डूइंग भजन एंड ही सेइंग दैट दो आई हैव टेकन इनकार्नेशन, आई हैव टेकन इनिशिएशन, आई एम डूइंग भजन ऑल्सो एंड ए मंथ हैज गॉन डूइंग माई नियम, but still Shri Krishna is not giving his darshan, Krishna is not, so that is asattvara. Asattvara, he should have patience. Asattvara, unpatient, he should not be unpatient. So asattvara, artha jigyasa, he should always try to know the earth. Anasuyu, without jealousy, amohva, and sometimes his vaak should be, his speaking should be, amoh means sati, moh means that is not working, effectless, and amohva means his vachan should be very much effective, amohva. जायापत्ति ग्रह क्षेत्र क्षेत्र स्वजन ध्रवण आदिशु उदासीन एंड यू शुड बी उदासीन न्यूट्रल टू जाया वाय अपत्य ग्रह क्षेत्र स्वजन हिज फ्रेंड्स एंड ध्रुविण हिज वेल्थ अबाउट दैट ही शुड बी न्यूट्रल ही शुड have the concern with them only so that his life journey can be moved on to this. So udasana, samapashan sarveshwartheshu mevatmana, and he should see that whatever I like for me, the other person would like the same thing. So we should not behave the other person which I dislike. So which I dislike for myself, I should not do that activity for others. So sarva artheshu eva atmanah, he should behave like himself to the other person. So, and by Vivek, he will be, in this way, he will be udasin or sarveshu artheshu. And by to other things, he should be udasin, neutral. One saint was saying that a person was giving, was abusing. And he was abusing, very bitter abuses. But just think, whatever he is saying, does he have any connection with that? Or I have any connection with that? If I do not have any connection, or I do not have any connection with that thing, then he is speaking lie. So I should not be part of it. कोई कहे तू बड़ा चोर है, तू बड़ा भ्रष्ट व्यभिचारी है, जरा सोचो क्या मैं व्यभिचारी हूं? अभी नहीं हूं तब यह तू कहता ना, तू झूठ बोल रहा है तो गाली का सकती होगा मेरे ऊपर। मैंने चोरी नहीं की है तो वो यदि वो गाली दे रहा है तो मेरे ऊपर असर नहीं होगा। और यदि वो कहता है कि मैं तेरे घर का मालिक हूं, तो क्या तू मेरे घर का मालिक है? क्या नहीं है इसका मतलब तू झूठ बोल रहा है, तू कहता रहा, इसका कोई असर नहीं होता। सो दिस, तो ये है, सब वस्तुओं से अपने आप को न्यूट्रल करके देख। सो उदासीन सम क्वेश्चन, सो सर्वे सर्वेषु एवात्म विलक्षण स्थूल सूक्ष्म देहा आत्मेक्षता स्वदृक विलक्षण स्थूल सूक्ष्म। यू शुड थिंक दैट ब्रह्म इज विलक्षण एंड नाउ ही इज स्टार्टिंग द क्वालिटीज ऑफ ब्रह्म एंड श्री गुरु शुड बी मदात्मक एंड ही शुड हैव दिस आइडिया इन हिज माइंड। इफ ए पर्सन इज सच देन वी शुड टेक तस्मात गुरु प्रपद्य तो वी शुड गो टू गुरु अब मध्य विज्ञम गुरु शांतम उपासना। सो नाउ श्री कृष्ण से दैट एंड श्री कृष्ण विल नाउ से दैट द बंधन इज टू द डेजिग्नेशन, बंधन इज नॉट टू सोल। सो इन दिस वे giving the definition or the giving the qualities of Brahma, now he, Shri Krishna will say that the all bandhan is to the designation upadhi ko bandhan hai, dehi ko bandhan hai, atma ko bandhan nahi. This he will describe on. Now,